Happy Rails to you. Welcome back, my friends. Happy Rails to you. It's good to see you again. Thanks for watching the channel and the videos. Sometimes they go real fast and sometimes they're slow. Happy Rails to you. Thanks for watching. All right, guys, we're back. I made two more braces. One there and one there. I've got them just tacked in with glue. Just set them in there. And now I'm going to seal them in with hot glue. Try anyway. Okay. Get the strings all off of it. And off of me. Turn it this way. This is what it looks like now. Now we've got three ribs, four with the center rib or the spine. It's like a spider web in there. So, and as you can see, once again, the light comes through. Set it right here. See how that light? See the difference? All right, so now we have completed roof. Our building structure is now solid. So it was pretty solid to begin with. We have doors yet to make, and whether we're going to make one long door that supposedly would be an automatic door that would raise up with either with a motor like a garage door, or whether they would crank it would be a manual, and they would crank it and have a cable or a chain on it and pull it up, or whether we'll have two doors that manually open. Put our doors on, paint it, put our sign on, get our signage up, our lettering, and we'll let it dry, and it'll be ready to go on the layout. So, let me get the material to make the doors, and then we'll go from there. Okay, so got our material. I just cut a piece off of it. This is my favorite old standby the patio door blind. We'll sand these edges off a little bit. Sit in here, like so. And then we'll raise it up and push it in like so. This is not sitting level because my mat that I work on is higher on one side than it is on the other. So, but anyway, you get the idea. So, I've got to make my runners. Fortunately, the way the building's made, I already have them started on both sides, one here and one here. This one is broke off on the end, so I'm going to recreate it, repair it. I'm going to do the same a little bit because it's broke a little bit on one end on this end. I'm going to do the same thing here, and then we're going to make our stops. And we should be in business. Let's see. Should be more than enough material right here to do what we got to do. So we're going to make our upper band first. Now I'd like to use something a little more sturdy, but once this is in place, it'd be just fine. You'd get a more uniform, straighter cut than that, though. I don't know why I'm still using these big scissors. Now, I could use my craft sticks or popsicle sticks, but they're not long enough, so I'd have to put two of them together. There we go. Use that door. And use this. I think we'll go with this. Okay, so once again, we're not going to use the regular glue on this. We're just going to go ahead and tack it in with hot glue. But before we do that, we're going to go ahead and complete our ridge, although I don't need it there. We're going to go ahead and add some to it anyway. Instead of just piecing in the piece that's broke off. Okay, so we added two struts, if you will. I don't know whether you can see them or not. Try to get them in the light. There's one there. And one on this bottom side, right there, on top of our rail. Now to make the rail itself a little wider. And then when we add our roller, which is now tighter than it was, which is strange. Okay, it's okay. We'll just cut it off a little bit. There. There. It had already tightened up on me. in this. Sorry guys for the angle, but I gotta move it back over this way so I can actually work on it. Trying to get them equal in equal positioning. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Plug our glue gun back up. While it's getting hot again, I think I'm going to go ahead and I wasn't going to use the glue again, but on this, so it really needs a few minutes to set up before I go hot gluing it in. But we're going to go ahead and put it in. Way it will be already sitting where it should be. We're going to let this sit just a few minutes, and then we're going to let the glue gun, while the glue gun gets hot, and then we'll tack it in place. All right, here we go. Well, my glue gun is clogged. Hold on. Now and then, my glue gun has its own mind and has its own way it wants to do things. So, I have to correct it. Let it know that it's not the boss. Now, while we're at it, we're going to put our guides in. What I'm using for a guide is matchsticks. So we'll go ahead and put matchsticks in. I actually need to get some new glue sticks, y'all. These glue sticks are very old. Not sure how very, but very. I know they're at least 2 or 3 years old, if not older. I'll just spew some glue here. I apologize, I know you can't see this, but I'm doing the same thing on this side. This blue is drying so fast, guys. Cooling down so fast, I can't. It's kind of unusual. The glue to cool down this fast. That line up. Okay. Okay, once we've gotten that in place, which we have. Take our door once again. Okay, what's going on? Oh, I see. This one over here shifted on us. Oh, man. All right, guys, we got that adjusted. And we went on, moved on to putting in our guides, our stops. Got them set. We went ahead and painted the door. Here's the back side of it. Here's the front side. And the building. We've also got our sign on it, Kansas, Colorado, and Texas United Rail Car, Repair Shop Number 1, Kansarado, Texas. Of course, it doesn't exist. And here is the building after it's painted. I was trying to keep the make it a little more real effect and make it a little rustic. Here's our chimney. course, you can see our building roof frame through the top of the building. There's the backside. Need to do a little touch up right there, I notice. And again, the front of the building. I'd mentioned probably motorizing this, and I might do that later on, but as of right now, I'm not looking at doing that. It would be a nice effect. Or even if I put some type of handheld deal that would enable me to raise it up would be great. But for now, I'm happy with this. This works great. And the building is completed and ready to set on the layout. So, in the next episode, we'll be back on the layout, working on the layout. And we'll start with finishing up our track plan for the rail repair yard and staging yard and get this building set. And then we'll go from there. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Remember, God is love, and Jesus Christ loves you. And I bid you all a happy rails until next time. This has been a Catzilla production, 2024. Bye-bye.